you.
Oh, no, not
well, you gotta, at least you could say hello or something.
Hello.
How are you? Who'd you all bring with you?
Pardon me?
Who's all with you?
Well, let me see now. I can't think.
Kay and Raleigh and...
Yeah,
that's
everybody.
It.
You're back here.
Yeah, I don't like close-ups either. Come on, let's get away. You always look better.
Yeah.
Vicki, you
know,
haven't met Raleigh. This is Kay's husband, Raleigh. Raleigh Ellingson, Bill. Raleigh Ellingson. This is Kay, my cousin Kay's husband.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Oh, well.
Trying to get pictures of her.
She doesn't like close-ups when
like
she walks right
too.
In front of the picture, huh? Boy, there's a coffee clutch over there. Yeah.
Hey, that's Vernon. Vernon Scrine, my cousin died. That's his wife, Jenny.
Okay.
One of her sons is a doctor. And, huh?
She thinks so.
Straighten out, Dorothy. Yeah. That lunch and dinner business, or are you still mixed up?
I'm still working on that. You know, I don't get anything. I don't get anything else done because I worry about that.
Are you still mixed up?
Lunch and dinner.
Oh, she.
He calls the evening meal supper.
She's
got
that
whole deal mixed up. It's dinner in the snow.
I miss my morning lunch. And morning lunch. Dorothy's got it figured out.
No, we just have to sit there. Because that's how we used to call it too. It was breakfast, dinner, and supper.
Are you kidding?
I'm still getting my flight for today. You'll probably see it.
Yeah, the light.
Great, thanks.
It's been a busy night.
Hi.
How are you, Bill?
Hello, Bill.
Gorgeous day. Who put the order in for it?
We did. We've been praying.
Together, yeah. Why, it pays off. So you got to know something in higher life.
Hello, how are you? Smile and say something to all your people. Huh?
I've been smiling for since 12:30.
Did you put Vaseline on your cheek?
Is that what you do?
Bill. These gals talking together.
Thank you.
celebrate the marriage of Cameron Gray. In thinking about this day, they have been given a rich heritage in marriage in which to follow on from both sides of the family. On Greg's side, Lyle and Marilyn have been married for 31 years this past summer. His grandparents, Joe and Grace Hamilton from California, who are not here with us, have been married for 60 years. Ralph and Dorothy Hintermeister, who are here with us today, have been married for 62 years. On Karen's side, Betty and I have been married 31 years this summer. Her grandparents, or my parents, have been married, or will have been married 60 years on this coming December. John and Evelyn Dunham, who are no longer with us, were married for 27 years before her mom died just after we were married in 1962. Have you been adding? That's 281 years of marriage in this family. So we pray that Karen and Greg will uphold this fine tradition. We especially want to remember Betty's parents today. Her mom loved weddings and was very much involved in the planning of our wedding and the weddings of Betty's cousins. And many of them are here today. We need to thank them for that. And weddings are important to us, and we are most happy that you can be a part of this with us today. Now a couple of housekeeping announcements. Karen and Greg have asked that only the parents stand when she comes down the aisle with her father. And please don't use flash cameras during the ceremony. And then after the ceremony, we're all invited into the fellowship hall where we'll have some punch and coffee while we go through the receiving line. Last year at this time, Nate Schilling was up here and he said to all your fathers, he said he just had two things to say. That he hoped he only had one daughter, and I can agree with that. And that last week before the wedding, no matter how silly it sounds, no matter how dumb it sounds, no matter what they ask you to do, just do it.
Put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you are called to peace, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom, and as you sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him.
Today to help you remember. You've taken a lot of pictures and videos. lot of things. These rings are also to help you to remember this day. You kind of look at them every day. It's a symbol of marriage in many ways. A purity of gold symbolizes a purity of your love for each other and of God's love for you. And also, the unending circle is a reminder of your unending vow, which you take until death do you part. The gold reminds you that Jesus became poor, that you could become rich, rich in your relationship to each other and in your relationship to the Lord because of his unending, unconditional love for you. Lord, bless these rings that every day they may speak a message of love, of purity of love, of unending love till death, of a richness of life together as they live together and grow together in your love. In Jesus' name, amen. I give you this ring. A symbol of my love and commitment to you.
A symbol of my love and commitment to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
I give you this ring.
This ring.
As a symbol of my love and commitment to you.
As a symbol of my love and commitment to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Join your right hands. Greg and Karen, by their promises before God and in the presence of this congregation, have bound themselves to one another as husband and wife. Blessed be the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Those whom God hath joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen.
Our home will be a refuge of unconditional love.
created our first parents and established them in marriage, establish and sustain you that you may find delight in each other, grow in holy love until your life's end. And you sense him with you daily to tune the instruments of your lives so you can have a sense of oneness, of harmony, of unity in him. For he does break down the walls that would separate us. He does forgive the words that we use as weapons. He does encourage us day by day to live in the power of his grace and his patience and his unconditional love at work in us. And Lord, even as I bless Greg and Karen, I would pray your blessing on every marriage represented here today, that each couple may cherish the instrument that they are and that their partner is, that they would seek your grace and your guidance to play love songs day by day to one another by their words and attitudes and life, by their actions and all that they are. Pray that there would be many Christian marriages that would lobby for the glory and adventure of walking together as husband and wife, and the commitment that lasts until death. Oh, just bless Karen and Greg and encourage them day by day with the love song that they can write for each other, by words and actions and attitudes. Whatever they do, they can do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father for each other and for you, who died for us, that we can live now and live forever. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's then sing a blessing as they get indicated on the program. Really happy to present to you Greg and Karen Hintermeister.
Do you feel any different? No, you don't feel like a Hintermeister yet?
No. No. Not to live in the
Don't ask me.
too fast.